Okay, so this is going to be a two-for-one look. I'm going to make two videos if I don't have enough time on the first one. But this is Alice and Queen Alice, because if you've read the book, you know that she becomes a queen at some point. And the song is actually called Blue Orchids, so blue orchids. Haha, how lucky! Right, so this is Alice right here. This is kind of the simplified look, and that's what the first video is going to be. This side is Queen Alice, and it's a little more shimmery, a little more like a mask or a porcelain, or a stylized porcelain doll look. For both, I wanted kind of a porcelain doll skin complexion look. I didn't have the time or the inclination to actually base my whole face because it was the stuff that goes on top of it that concerned me the most, and I didn't put mascara on or do my brows or anything. Just because I wanted to get the general look up. If you enjoy the look, and if you use it and put your own spin on it, please, please, please feel free to go ahead and post a video response of your look, whether it's a slideshow or whatever. I would love to see it. If you use any of my looks for Halloween and put your own spin on it, or, you know, do it yourself, or, you know, whatever, make a costume based on it or to go with it. You know, even if it's not the original character that I intended, like you see the Mad Hatter, but you think it fits, I don't know, Mock Turtle, who knows? Go ahead and, you know, put it together and post it. I would love to see it. It'd be fun. So let's get started with Alice before I jabber away and take up all my time. Okie dokie. So we're going to start with Alice, just plain Alice, not Queen Alice, on this side. I'm already primed and all that good stuff. So we're going to take this color. It's Blue Lagoon. Blue Lagoon, okay. We're going to take Blue Lagoon on our little brush. And then on the lid, just gonna go right across. Gonna take the lighter blue, which is actually a highlighter from, I think they call it the Something Blue Duo. Go right into the corner and blend it out. And then I'm gonna grab, this is actually a very quick look, so it's good for like if you're wearing a costume to school and you don't want to just be like fwah, or if you just aren't into the big glam stuff, you can just something nice and simple but kind of pizzazzy. So then we're going to take Goddess, nice dark color right there, and go right in the crease, not all the way across, just into the outer half. Kick that out a little bit, make it kind of smoky looking. And then I'm going to take that Goddess again and go about halfway across, and then just kind of smudge it with your finger to blend it towards the center. And that's done real quick. So the next thing we're going to grab is dark blue liquid liner. We're going to go start about halfway across and work towards the outside. like to start halfway and then go back and blend in from the corner. So you've got that, and you've kind of kicked it out on the side leg. So fan it. If you want, you can, at this point, take a little bit of polyester bride or some shimmering white, whatever you've got. Not everybody has Urban Decay, which is fine. Take your little brush, wipe it off on your paper towel, pick up a little polyester bride, not a whole lot, and then just right up above the brow bone, blend it down a little bit into the goddess. And brighten up the corner if you want a little bit. So, nice and simple kind of look. You would add, of course, mascara, but I'm not going to do that for this one because this is mostly lip blush, lip rouge, it's a powder. It's going to take a little bit. Go right on the cheekbone. Yes, I know it looks bright, but you're going to tone it down by blending with finger. To get that kind of sweet, pretty look. Okay. And then for the lips, for both look, I'm gonna use the same base, but then I'm gonna throw something fancy on the top of it. This is Tangy Lipstick. If you don't know what this is, it's been around forever, but it looks orange in the tube, and it goes on clear, but then it uses your skin chemistry to change color. So I'll show you what happens. Hang on. And so on me, it turns to this color. On you, it might change. You can get it at, I think, the Vermont Country Store or something like that. Just look it up. It's T-A-N-G-E-E, if you think it's interesting. I kind of like it, just because, you know, some days it looks like this, some days it's brighter, you know. But this is going to be your base lip color for either look. So either that, or you can use a naturally kind of, this is Alice to get you started, and then I'm going to do Queen Alice here in a minute. So.